This is the setup process for the Wyze Cam Outdoor. It is a two-part process because you have the base station that lives inside, and then you have the Wyze Cam Outdoor over there, and then here I have the cable for charging the Wyze Cam Outdoor if we need it. I will be using all of the included wiring, so the Ethernet cable that comes with base station, as well as the power adapter. So step one is obviously get everything out of the box. Step two is coming into your Wyze app, selecting the plus sign, select add a new device, and then here you could see there's base station and Wyze Cam Outdoor. We are going to select the base station. So what we're going to do is connect your mobile network to the device. Okay, so what this is, we need to make sure that our network that we're on is going to be the same network that our base station is on. So in my case, I'm just going to switch over to my IoT network very quickly on my cell phone just to make sure, and we're going to hit next. So here we're going to plug the base station into your power and router. So powering up the device and adding the Ethernet cable. So we're going to put down the cell phone for a moment, and like I said, grabbing the included cableage, we're going to plug in the power, and then we're going to come over and say we got orange on top, and then we're going to plug in the Ethernet cable and put that down. So we're going to give that a moment because we have the light will flash blue and remain solid once connected. So we're going to give that a moment to do what it's going to do because right now it is orange. And we're going to see how long that actually takes to do it. And sadly, this is kind of where it's going to live for the rest of the setup process because, well, the Ethernet cable that comes with the outdoor cam, not terribly long. So not terrible if you're going to have it really close to your base station or your Wi-Fi router. In my case, the Asus one, I'll link over in the corner there, but not really good for if you're trying to set this up far away. All right, there we go. It's flashing blue. And once it's a solid blue, we will know it's connected. So there we go. It is connected to my network. So coming back to the application here, we can put a check mark next to the status light is solid blue, because there we can see solid blue, and select next. So I can try again, or I can set it up using the QR code. I'm gonna try again. And what I think may be happening is because I have a separate Wi-Fi network for my IoT devices that it is not going to be sitting on my IoT network. It's actually going to be sitting on my main network. So let me swap. All right, so I've swapped over to my 5 GHz main network, and I'm going to give that a shot. And if that doesn't work, I will switch over to the 2.4 gig network. And if that doesn't work, I will set it up with the QR code. That's what it is. So we're going to give it a name. So camera name, all right, so we'll rename that, but I don't necessarily know that I like that it's sitting on my main network and does not allow me to put it on my IoT network. Well, here we go, we're gonna add a new device and we're gonna add the actual outdoor camera now. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna come over to the device, flip it up, turn the power button on. The status light will be a solid yellow. Keep the cam within 6 feet of the base station during setup, and if light does not turn on, please plug in and charge your camera. So let's see what we got here. I've already pre-done opening the base station, so we're gonna flip that switch up, and that puts it in the on position. Now mine is yellow, so this should mean that I have enough power to actually link this to the base station. Now I had seen some other reviews that, you know, they had to charge it first, but we're gonna try this and see what we got. Press the sync button on the bottom of the camera. So we're just gonna come around here. There is our sync button.
Pairing is in progress, please wait.
All right, hopefully you heard that. Pairing is in progress, please wait. And now you can see on the back there, it is flashing blue and yellow.
Setup is complete.
And there it says setup is complete. All right, and we can set up different names for it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna call this backyard for now and hit finish. We can select sharing the device if we want to. We're gonna say maybe later because we're not gonna do that. And then begin mounting. It's gonna walk you through the mounting process. I'm going to skip this for now, only because I'm actually just going to be placing this outside while I test it until I find an actual spot that I'd like to keep it. So, quick setup unlocked, add new outdoor cameras by pressing quick setup. Okay, so that's base station stuff. We'll talk about that later. This is part of the starter bundle, so everything we had to do manually. So I'm just gonna say, got it. And then here we go, one last thing. It's kind of showing me all the things. We're gonna say all set. And then obviously we're gonna have to upgrade the firmware, so we're gonna select upgrade the firmware. So there were actually two firmwares that I had to do, one for the base station and one for the outdoor camera itself.